chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, ranks as the third leading cause of death in the United States, trailing just behind heart disease and cancer. For most COPD patients, vigilant symptom management means better quality of life. However, progression of the disease is inevitable. For patients like Larry, disease progression is the only sure thing about COPD. Take a look.
Well, I first was diagnosed with COPD in 2004. I had already stopped running just about that time, just simply because it was so difficult for me to catch my breath and continue on. It seems like every year I notice a little bit of a change. Even over the last year or two, I notice a change. From one year to the next, a little less capacity to breathe. It affected my lifestyle mostly because I was active with physical training and have classes for physical training for seniors. And it was getting to the point where I couldn't exert during those. And even simple things like working around the yard, I would get up, I'd have to stop and catch my breath, sometimes just go back down just to be able to breathe for a moment. COPD is always progressive, but then aging is as well. And if you can stop the COPD rapid progression, then I would progress normally in my lung function. And that's really what I was looking for, a way for me not to have to rely on extraordinary means to catch my breath and to feel better.
Patients like Larry are not alone. In fact, COPD affects over 24 million Americans. Despite advances in medicine, the standard of care for COPD treatment has remained relatively unchanged over the past few decades, leaving patients with few options. What if there was a way to potentially slow the progression of the disease using the patient's own stem cells? Well, joining me today to discuss the alternative to traditional treatment options for COPD is Dr. James St. Louis from the Lung Institute. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me, Erica.
So let's get right to it, Doctor. What exactly is COPD and what are the current treatments?
COPD is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which includes chronic bronchitis and emphysema. And the traditional treatments right now would be nebulizers, medication, and a variety of other treatments that treat the symptoms of the disease. To actually treat the disease would be a lung transplant. At the Lung Institute, we treat the COPD and other lung diseases with stem cell therapy. Stem cells are the body's natural healing cells. They reduce the inflammation in your body. Inflammation causes many diseases in the body. So you can use your own cells to decrease the inflammation.
So the process of harvesting stem cells sounds incredibly complicated. What is that process like?
It's actually very simple. You can take your blood and separate the stem cells out. And the other way of doing it is using your bone marrow, which is also a very simple procedure. And then we separate out the stem cells and then put them back into your body using an IV.
So how are you getting the stem cells to target the lung specifically?
Stem cells, after we harvest them and return them into your body, and they circulate to the right side of your heart. And then from the right side of your heart, they're pushed into the lungs, but the stem cells go into a part of the lung called a pulmonary trap, and they stay in this pulmonary trap, and then they are dispersed primarily to the lung.
So then what are the risks and what are the results?
The risks are very minimal if you just sit back and think about it, because it's your own cells.
Right.
You're not introducing anything foreign into your body, so the risks are very minimal. The results show at about 3 months, the patients have an increased quality of life. Some person had fairly severe disease and they were on oxygen 24 hours a day, so now they're on oxygen much less, but they can go simple things like go to the grocery store, do daily activities versus how they were before.
So what is the ultimate goal at the Lung Institute?
Our goal from the technical part is to increase, in some cases, your lung function, which goes hand in hand with increasing your quality of life.
This sounds like a great option for so many people. And we met with Larry at the top of the show, if you remember. So let's check in with him again to see how he's doing.
In 2014, my condition was progressing, of course, to the point where I couldn't participate in things as well as I wanted to. And I did read an ad in the newspaper about Lung Institute. I made the decision to proceed, and the procedure was very simple, straightforward, and not uncomfortable at all. They asked me to keep a journal, and the results of that was that I saw that over a period of about 3 weeks, I gradually had some improvement in lung function and ability to do my exercise programs. After my last treatment, I had really good results, and before that, I couldn't breathe very well and had to let up and rest during my aerobic exercises. But right after the treatment, I found that I was able to do the whole exercise, and I didn't have any problem with breathing. With the positive results I've had, I really look forward to the future. Perhaps we can get more involved in stem cells. Perhaps we can actually make better things happen. And I'm really hopeful for the future, particularly not from necessarily for myself, but for others who may have problems similar to mine, that there is maybe a path to recovery.
We are so happy to see that Larry is doing well. Now, Doctor, the Lung Institute uses stem cell therapy to treat other lung diseases as well.
That's correct. We treat major pulmonary lung diseases, which, as I said before, COPD, which is emphysema, chronic bronchitis. And then we also treat interstitial lung disease, which one of those is pulmonary fibrosis.
For those out there who are suffering from COPD or other lung disease, they now know that there's an alternative. Thank you, Doctor, so much for joining
us. You're welcome.
For more on the alternative treatment options discussed here today, go to lunginstitute.com. And of course, you can find all of these resources on our website as well, accesshealth.tv. Thank you so much, Doctor.